Hello everybody and a good day to you all. Today I'm talking about the television series Mr. Robot, starring Rami Malek, Carla Chalkin, Portia Doubleday, and Christian Slater. In this show, you follow Elliot Alderson. Elliot Alderson he's mentally ill. He has a trouble telling reality from fiction. He can't tell the difference, and sometimes he's not in control of his actions because he feels as though somebody else takes over and does it for him, and he blacks out through these moments. He doesn't know how he ends up in certain situations or who's actually in charge. But even though he's mentally ill, he has a job working for a company called AllSafe, where he is a tech guy. He makes sure other companies can't get hacked. And he gets to the system, secures the system, and makes it strong enough so hackers can't get in and mess them up. But on his spare time, he is a hacker. And he goes around hacking people who he feels as though do wrong. So the only way he knows how to fix it, he hacks you and exposes you to the world. And then that you get caught, and he feels as though he did a good deed. To him, he's a superhero fighting crime. But instead of using his fists, he uses his mind and his computer. But he doesn't only just hack bad guys. He hacks everybody. Because since Elliot is mentally ill, he doesn't really know how to connect with other people. He doesn't know how to express his feelings or say how what's going on in his mind. And I mean, he's more inside his head, and he wants to say what's inside his head. It doesn't make people know what's going on, but he doesn't know how to do that. So the only way he feels as though he needs to connect with somebody, he has to hack them. Good or bad. And even if he thinks you're good, he's going to hack you. And to him, that's like bringing their connection closer together. But even though that's messed up, that's the only way he feels as though he can connect with you on an emotional level. And he does have people in his life who do care about him. He has three people in his life that actually do care about him. He has Darlene, Angela, and Shyla. Now, Angela is his childhood friend. And they became friends because they both lost their parents because of a company called Evil Corp. And because of that loss, forced them to have a bond with each other. And she understood Elliot, even though he's not well mentally, but she was able to connect with him, and he also was able to connect with her as well. She's one of the few people who he actually like let into his life. And then you have Shayla, who is his girlfriend / drug dealer. Now, at first, he kept it more professional, even though you can tell from the start she actually did like him. And he probably was attracted to her too, but he doesn't know how to express it. And he tried to keep it separate because she supplied him drugs. And in his head, he didn't want to like blur the lines between them because he's not really a drug addict. But even though that's what he is, he's in a complete denial of that. Even though he's totally hooked on these drugs, and even though she's supplying drugs to him, she's also helping him in a way because he had a certain rules that he had. And even though she applied him the drug, she even helped him with his rules because she didn't want him to get hurt because of it. It's kind of weird. Like, she's giving him drugs that are hurting him, but yet she's trying to make sure he doesn't get hurt at the same time. It's just weird. And then you have Darlene. Now, I don't want to say who Darlene is yet, who Darlene is, because I don't want to spoil it. Because if you haven't been watching the show, if I tell you who Darlene is, it's going to ruin the whole surprise. I don't want to do that. But these three people actually do care about him, and he actually do let into his life. And he also has, while he's hacking, he's formed a group called F Society, and they go around righting the wrongs that going on in the world, and their big target is Evil Corp. Now, Evil Corp is this mega corporation that has their hands in a whole lot of different things, from the phone you use, to the computers, to the cards, to the credit cards. Almost everything is run by evil corp in some type of way. Even his company Allstate is partnered with evil corp. And the F Society, their plan is to take down evil corp because they have, even though they employ a lot of people, they are involved in a whole lot of dirty things. And he feels, since he has the need to like save people and be a superhero, he's going to use his mind to take down this evil corporation with the help of other hackers. And that's pretty much, and you follow Elliot on his journey in each and every episode. Yes, there are other people in the show as well, and they also show their lives and their focus, but Elliot is the main star of the whole show. But I'm going to tell you this right now, people, and I am sincere about this. I love this show. From the first episode, when Elliot hacked someone at a bakery, and he explained why he hacked them and everything, I was hooked. Each episode just gets better and better and better. The acting performances in this show is fantastic from the whole cast. Everybody is enjoyable to watch. Even when they're not focused on Elliot, enjoyable to watch. Everybody in this show, in some type of way, is messed up. Either mentally, emotionally, or morally. And when I say morally messed up, I'm talking about the CEO of Evil Corp. This man is the devil. I'm surprised he didn't have horns, because there are times when he actually can be quite charming and you actually start to like him. Oh my God, he's a sweet old man. I could be his friend. And then the next moment, he can say something that's so sick and so twisted, it hurts your soul. Oh my gosh. Again, I love this show. I highly recommend it. It's really, really, really good. Now, giving this show a grade, I'm giving it an A+. Oh my gosh. If you haven't been watching it, I say watch it now. Really, I mean really watch it now. Just start watching it. Everything, like I said, the acting performances were good. The way it was shot was fantastic. From the opening scene, when the title came up, Mr. Robot, that looked amazing. From the font they used, the music, from the classical music they played to all the way down to the techno, brought an intensity to the show. It added a more of a drama and a more oomph to the show. You actually can feel what's going on through the show by the music. Again, I love this show. I cannot recommend it enough. And I also want to give a shout out and a thank you to Josh Relyea. He's a YouTuber. He does reaction videos and movie reviews. I'm going to link down below to his channel. I say check him out. If you like his videos, give him a big old like and thumbs up. And if you really like his videos, subscribe to his channel. He's a cool guy. He suggested this show to me. And I want to say thank you for that, because I really did love this show. And I suggest that y'all watch it too. So that's all I got to say about that. So give my channel a big old like. Hit the thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel and share. I really would appreciate it. So like I always say, in my dreams and in real life, I am the Ninja Rabbit. Peace out, peoples.